So good afternoon viewers, welcome back, welcome once again. In this session we are going to discuss India's freedom movement up to civil disobedience movement we have discussed. Now finally at last India wins the freedom. So after the Second World War, which took place in between 1939 to 1945, the economic, military and political strength of Britain was greatly reduced. So economic, military and political strength of Britain got reduced, because of which they realized that it would be difficult to rule India under these conditions. Moreover, mass movements like Quit India movement were gaining momentum. That means movements, mass movements, people's movement like Quit India movement was also on a full flow. The Indian National Army was also becoming powerful. Because of all these factors, the British government decided to discuss the issues related to India's independence with the leaders of INC, Indian National Congress, and finally granted the independence on 15th August 1947. So because their economic, military and political strength of Britain was reduced, it got downtrodden. Economic means their wealth condition, military, that means manpower, resources, and political means their political organization, the administration through which they were ruling in the country. So everything was greatly reduced, everything was hampered because of the Second World War, because of which they were not at all in a position to rule over our country India. And that's why they have decided to leave the country, and this thing they have discussed with the leaders, with the prominent leaders of INC, that is Indian National Congress, and finally granted the independence on 15th August 1947. Okay, so this was a small story about the chapter. Coming on to the question answer part, from tick the correct answer, four options are there. I have given the answer only, so be very careful. Where was the Indian National Congress formed? So where, at which place this Indian National Congress got formed? So the Indian National Congress got formed in Bombay. In which year was Bengal partitioned? You might be very much aware, you might be very much acquainted with the fact. Moreover, you might have remembered that the Bengal was partitioned in the year 1905 by Lord Curzon. Yes, remembered? Telling that it will be good to administer or to effectively administer over a large part of Bengal, having such a huge population. That's why he has partitioned the Bengal in the year 1905. Another question, as part of which movement did the INC decide to celebrate 26 January 1930 as India's Independence Day? So you might very much remember that due to civil disobedience movement, in which Gandhiji has broken the salt law, also walked from Sabarmati ashram to Dandi, many people got arrested also, but Gandhiji was adamant that he is going to make the salt so that Indians will get the right of making the salt. And if they are going to make the salt, then they need not to pay the tax to the Britisher, because they have already taken the oath, or they are through to the path of not to cooperate Britisher. They were always thinking of not to cooperate the Britisher, because of which these Swadeshi movement, non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement, all these things have got a mass movement, all these things were gaining momentum. So it was a civil disobedience movement, as a part of which INC decide to celebrate 26 January 1930 as India's Independence Day. Another question, which of the following were the characteristics of the non-cooperation movement? So the four options were given. So the characteristic of non-cooperation movement was all of the above options. As you can see in the book, it is not to pay the taxes, not to take part in the elections, boycotting British goods. All these factors were the characteristic of non-cooperation movement. And because of that, the answer is all of the above. Another question, in which year was the Quit India movement launched? So in which year Quit India movement was launched? So you might be very much remembering that in the year 1942, the Quit India movement was launched. So Quit India movement was launched in the year 1942. These are the some of the important questions of choosing or tick the correct answer, okay, in which you are selecting the correct answers. Moving on to the next, we have true and false. So write T for true statements and write F for false statements. The first statement, the first meeting of the INC, Indian National Congress, was attended by 72 representatives from all over the country. Yes, very true statement. So only 72 representatives comprising of journalists, reformers and lawyers have attended that meeting held in Bombay, right? In 1885, right? Gandhiji called off the non-cooperation movement in 1920 as a result of widespread violence across the country. So this statement is false. I have rectified. I have given it in the answer key. Okay. Why? Because the year over here is wrong. Okay. It is 1922, not 1920. Okay. So mind you that in this question, be very careful. You should put it false. I have rectified and I have given it in answer key. So you should also be very much sincere towards it. Okay. In front of you, I am rectifying it so that you can also remember that sir has rectified it. So it is the right answer. Okay. Yes. So Gandhiji called off the non-cooperation movement in 1922 as a result of widespread violence across the country. So it is a false statement because Gandhiji called off the non-cooperation movement because of widespread violence across the country, but year was 1922. Another question, do or die was a slogan given by Subhash Chandra Bose. It is false. So do or die was slogan given by, yes, Mahatma Gandhi. He was not Subhash Chandra Bose. Another question, the Second World War took place between 1939 and 1945. Yes, that is very true because you might remember that in between 1939 to 1945, because of Second World War only, the economic, military and political condition of the Britisher got declined, got reduced. That's why they were not at all in a position to rule over the country, and that's why they flew away from our country. Moreover, some of the prominent movements, mass movements like Quit India movement and other movements were also gaining momentum, also keeping pace, also increased. That's why Britisher can't able to handle the pressure. Another question. The British banned the Indian National Congress after the Swadeshi movement. So British banned the Indian National Congress after Swadeshi movement. It is false statement. Okay. Britishers actually banned the Indian National Congress not after the Swadeshi movement, but after it was, you can say, आफ्टर क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट और यू कैन से यस आफ्टर क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट ओनली दे हैव बैंड इट ओके नॉट आफ्टर द स्वदेशी मूवमेंट. कमिंग ऑन टू द मैच द फॉलोइंग आई हैव ऑलरेडी मैच्ड इट सो मोर ओवर द नंबर इज प्लेस्ड ओके इन फ्रंट ऑफ इट सो इट इज मैच्ड वन. You need to match it by writing the numbers either or by writing the alphabet at the back of the options or else you can match it with the help of line by putting a by placing a line mark. Partition of Bengal. So Lord Curzon was responsible for it. So partition of Bengal has been done by Lord Curzon. Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Yes, it was ordered by General Reginald Dyer. General Reginald Dyer was responsible for it because of which that heavy massacre took place in which thousands of people lost their life. So, General Reginald Dyer is the right option over here. Indian National Army. Yes, it was been supported by Subhash Chandra Bose. So Subhash Chandra Bose is the right match for Indian National Army. Civil disobedience movement. It was Mahatma Gandhi. Yes, Mahatma Gandhi started the civil disobedience movement. Swaraj, it means self-government. So in this way, you can match the following parts. Okay. These are the answers of these questions. Coming on to the question answer in brief. First question, why did the British decide to partition Bengal? Why Britisher thought of making a partition of Bengal? The British decided to partition Bengal to administer the province, to administer the area, to administer the territory, to administer the kingdom effectively. Since it had huge population, because Bengal's population was very large, because Bengal's population was huge, that's why Britisher decided to partition Bengal to administer it effectively. That's it. Okay. Coming on to the next question. What were the characteristic features of the non-cooperation movement? So what are the characteristic features of the non-cooperation movement? First one, refusing to buy the British good. Nobody will buy the British good. Also refusal to pay the tax. Neither they will buy the British good nor they will pay the tax. Then boycotting government service. We will not take any government service. So boycotting the government service as well as boycotting any of the elections. We are not going to take part in any of the elections held by the Britishers. And to attain the Swaraj or self-government. These are the characteristic features of non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement ran with these salient features, with these features. The main aim behind this was not to cooperate the Britishers. That's why these are the characteristic features of non-cooperation movement. Another question. Write a short note on Dandi March. So you have to write a short note. What has happened in the Dandi March? Okay, you have to write a short note on it. Mahatma Gandhi and 78 of his followers, Mahatma Gandhi along with 78 followers marched, walked from Sabarmati Ashram to coastal town of Dandi. It took place in Gujarat only. So Sabarmati Ashram is also in Gujarat, you can say. So Mahatma Gandhi along with 78 of his followers marched from Sabarmati Ashram in Gujarat to coastal town of Dandi. Why he marched from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi? To break the salt law. Why it was necessary to break the salt law? Because Britishers have made a monopoly. They have made a policy that Britishers, that Indians are not allowed to produce the salt. And Gandhiji thought that it is such an essential component of the food that no food is being prepared without the salt. And if we are not going to make the salt, then if we are dependent over the Britishers for the salt, then we need to pay the tax to the Britisher whenever we are going to buy the salt. This was the motive. That's why Gandhiji thought of breaking the salt law, and that's why this incident happened. Thousands of people across the country joined Gandhiji in the march. So thousands of people from all across the country joined Gandhiji in the march and were arrested by the Britisher. Moreover, they were arrested also. On reaching Dandi, after reaching Dandi, they produced the salt without paying the tax. Huge struggle came about. Though Britisher have arrested many people, but Gandhiji has produced the salt, handful of salt, and this movement came to be known as Dandi March, and this was the Dandi March. Now answer in detail. How were the moderates in INC were different from radicals? Now there were two groups, moderate and radicals. Who were moderates and who were radicals? Freedom fighters were categorized as moderates and radicals. Leaders who felt that mass movement against the British were necessary to solve the problem, they were radicals. Garam Dal, Maro Ya Maro, like that people. So leaders who felt that Britisher will not give us anything, we need to seize them, we need to capture over the Britisher in order to get something. Those leaders were radicals who felt, who believed, who has a strong thought that mass movement is necessary against the Britishers to solve the problem being faced by Indians. If you need to solve the problem, you have to carry out a mass movement against the Britishers. You have to kill them. You have to capture Britisher. You have to take forcefully anything from them. They are not good people. They are not going to give you by prayer and petitions. One more question is attached to it, that name three moderate as well as three radicals. So leaders who felt that mass movement is necessary against the Britisher to solve the problem, they were radicals. Three radicals were Lal, Bal and Pal. Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal. They were radicals. They were very hot from blood, furious, angry people. And the leaders who believed, the leaders who thought that talks with the British would help to sort the issues. We will talk to the Britisher and they will listen to us. They will listen to the prayers and petitions. They were moderates, Naram Dal. They have a firm belief that if we will talk to the Britisher and if we will ask something by joining, by folding our hands, they will give us. They were moderates. Three moderates were Gopal Krishna Gokhale, G.K. Gokhale, Surendranath Banerjee and Dada Bhai Nauroji. Okay, so this is the answer to the first question. Answer in detail. Moving on to the next, write a note on the protests that happened after the partition of Bengal. As soon as the Bengal was partitioned by Lord Curzon, what were the protests that happened? How Indians were showing opposing nature? How Indians were showing their angerness? How they were showing that they are against the Britishers by means of protests? So how the protest took place, or what were the different forms of protest? How people were showing different protest in the form of Swadeshi movement occurred. Indians have started Swadeshi movement, as per according to which they have taken an oath not to help the Britisher. They have boycotted British goods. They have also taken an oath not to participate in any of the elections, not to participate in any of the Britisher program, not to become a part of the employment of government service. They started burning the imported clothes and started reviving, that means bringing back the Indian goods. Now they were using only Indian goods, and they were reviving, they were taking Indian goods. People of all kinds, educated and illiterate, either educated or illiterate, they started gathering in large numbers. In large number, people gather together at many of the places, discuss the issue with each other, and in this way the protest held against the British after the partition of Bengal. So altogether, the protest gained movement, the protest gained momentum. Okay. Another question: what were the reasons that led the British to grant independence to India? Why Britisher have given, granted means to give. Why the Britishers have given the independence to India? So after the Second World War, that is from 1939 to 1945, you might be remembering, you should know that Second World War took place in between 1939 to 1945. Big countries have participated. Britain also got involved. Britisher also got involved with the Second World War. So after the Second World War, the economic, military and political strength of the Britain was greatly reduced. So it was greatly reduced. The military, political and economic strength of the British, of the Britain was greatly reduced. They realized that it would be difficult to rule India under these conditions. And they realized that it is difficult to rule India under such circumstance, under such condition. Moreover, mass movements like Quit India movement were gaining momentum. So these movements, Swadeshi movement, Quit India movement and all these movements were gaining momentum, were in full pace, were increased. The British government then decided to discuss the issues related to India's independence with leaders of INC. So finally, British government thought that they are going to discuss this issue with the leaders of INC, Indian National Congress. They have discussed this matter, and finally they have granted independence to India in August 1947. Obviously, if you are ruling over some country, then you need military power, you need money power, you need political power, administration power, which we can say. If these power are not lying with you, or if you are lacking, or there is scarcity of these kinds of power, you can't rule over the country. The same thing has happened with the Britisher also. They got engaged in the Second World War, एंड व्हेन अ कंट्री गेट्स इंगेज्ड विथ एनी ऑफ द वॉर देयर मिलिट्री पावर मनी पावर एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स गेट्स रिड्यूस्ड द सेम थिंग हैज हैपेंड देयर इकोनॉमिक मिलिट्री एंड पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रेंथ गॉट डिक्लाइंड गॉट रिड्यूस्ड बिकॉज ऑफ विच देयर पोजिशन देयर होल्ड ओवर इंडिया वॉज गेटिंग स्लैकेंड गेटिंग लूज becomes weaker, feeble. That's why they were not at all in a position to rule over our country India. And that's why they have decided that we will grant India their freedom and we will move from here. We will go out from India. We'll go to our own country. And finally, on 15th August 1947, they have given Indians their freedom. So, this is all about the chapter that we have read in this chapter. Next time, I'm going to come up with yet another chapter, new chapter. So till then, have a nice day. Have a wonderful day. Bye.